Hello everyone, welcome back to another Palm interview. In this video, I'm going to be doing a hairstyling tutorial. This is going to be jelly rolls and elephant trunks. I'm just going to do them in one video because they're pretty much the same thing. I decided to do this video after sort of like 2 months because I recently watched a film called Nowhere Boy, and that's about John Lennon and how he met Paul McCartney in the late 50s and how they started the Beatles. And in that film, Aaron Taylor-Johnson, his hair naturally is quite curly. Obviously mine isn't, but he has this awesome jelly roll elephant's trunk style hairstyle going on, which obviously at the time in Britain was very popular because all the teddy boys sported it, along with obviously slick backs and things like that. They were more popular in Britain than they were, I'd say, in America. The pompadour was obviously more American than British. So I'm going to first talk to you about what you're going to need. I'm only going to use four things. So I'm going to use my Denman vent brush just to get the nice curl inward. I find this easier to do with one of these than with a comb. But in addition to that, we will be using a comb. So I'm just using my cheap regular comb that you see in all the videos. So I'll be using that. Hair product wise, I'm just going to be using good old fashioned Brylcreem, because this was pretty much all they had in Britain at the time. America was more lucky in that respect because they had things like Lucky Tiger, Dixie Peach, Black and White, whereas in Britain it was harder to find pomades and things like that. And then lastly, obviously a small handheld mirror so I can do my duck's ass. So first off, you can see my hair is damp. Obviously my hair is trained to do a pompadour, but a side part pompadour, but you can do an elephant's trunk or jelly roll, depending on whatever hair you've got really. It's one of those hairstyles, it's probably a little bit easier if you've got wavier hair or slightly curlier hair, like my grandfather, that's what he used to have him back in the day. Was a jelly roll, and his hair's quite curly, quite naturally curly, so it just helps him because it usually just stay in place. Whereas someone like myself, where my hair is straight, it's a little bit trickier. So first off, I'm going to take my vent brush and I'm just going to start curling the sides upward, and then you want to curl it up like this, twist like that, and just drop it. If I'm going to do a jelly roll, usually I'll use a water-based pomade because obviously it just stays in there and you've just got the volume all day. But for this, I'm going to be using more traditional products just to get a better idea of it. And I figured Brylcreem, I should show a few more different hairstyles you can do with it, because that was suggested to me by one of the comments. So that's what I'm going to be doing. See, I'm just curling it in, taking my brush out, and the same in the back. Obviously, because my hair's cut for a side part pompadour, I've got the middle section which we'd usually brush over into the side part, but I've got to try and fight against that, so otherwise that part sticks up as well. So you're starting to get it now. You want to do it without any product. I know I've got buildup of a bit of black on my hair from the barbers today. I thought I'd get a fresh haircut before we start the tutorial. So once you've sort of got the shape, general shape going like this with damp hair, Which obviously, if you don't usually do one of these, it's much easier if you've got build up in your hair, because it just stays. So I'm just going to take a little bit of Brylcreem and just slick it through. Not much. Sort of try and keep the general shape of what we just did. Obviously, I will just go through the steps quite quickly. You should really let it dry a little bit more before you start applying a product and start going into the finish style. So just a decent amount of Brylcreem. But obviously, you could do this with any hairstyle, any hair product. Like, I'm sure in the movie, his hair didn't look very greasy. So I'm assuming they use like hairsprays and things like that just to set it in place. Or waxes rather than pomades and hair creams. Just because of all the takes they would have had to have done, so just keeps it in place all day. I suppose it would be so much easier for the hairstylist on set if they just used hairspray. So I'm going to put a little bit more on the front just to keep the curls going in. Okay, so that's that. Now I'm going to take my brush again. Same again. Now you just slick it back first, right? Same again now. Just keep curling in. Just like that. And the sides then, you want to bring up an angle up like that to the back of your head. And now you can see it's curling in at the top. And this is basically what how they styled George Travolta's hair for Grease, using that method, going up at an angle. And in case you're wondering what CD I'm listening to, is obviously the 68 Comeback Elvis special. So I'm just curling it in. It really doesn't matter in my case that it's a little bit messy, because it'd be different if my hair was trained for this, but obviously it's not. So you just want to keep curling it in, just bringing your brush out. As you get to the front, you just want to keep using the same technique. You just keep curling it in. It just takes a bit of patience if you're not used to it at all. So I'm just going to leave the front like that. What I tend to do is comb it back a little bit. Just take my brush out. And I've got a little bit of height down the front that stops it from sitting on my forehead. Because there's one thing I really hate about elephant trunks and things like that, is that it sits on your forehead, especially if you're quite young. And prone to spots, because obviously my forehead's greasy there, and it's just going to clog up my pores. I definitely don't want that. This is just a pain. This is kind of the basis as well for how Alex Turner used to style his hair. I know there's quite a few tutorials up there on how to style your hair like his. But his Teddy Boy Rockabilly phase, he styled it like three or four different ways throughout the whole period. Started off something like this, and then it evolved into just like a pompadour with the sides slicked up, and like you'd flick a little bit out, just to mess it up a bit. Obviously, if you were having your hair cut before an elephant trunk, your fringe would be much shorter than mine is. Mine comes down to the tip of my nose, but you'd want it a little bit shorter than that, because they usually hang just above the bridge of your nose, so somewhere in this region. the cap is annoying me because they stick up. I got no chance of platinum, so there's no point trying. So that's kind of what you want to go for. Obviously, it's a little bit tricky for me because my hair's for a pomp. So that's the front and the side. I'm just going to do my DA quickly. That's where the comb comes in. So I'm just going to take a seat. Well, it's not bad, but it's obviously not quite the way it should be. Let me just give you a quick overview. And then you can see the two sections just fold in perfectly. I suppose once you get better at this and your hair gets trained for it, you can just use a comb. Like, I have to use a brush just because makes it easier to curl it in, whereas if your hair is always going to do this style, then it's just going to curl in naturally for you. So I'm just going to leave it like that. That's one thing I always do. I say I'm going to leave it and then I just carry on. There you are. And that is my elephant trunk jelly roll tutorial. I highly recommend checking out No Web One. Really excellent film. I've never been a fan of the Beatles really, but I did enjoy that film. I suggest going to check it out anyway, if you're interested in that sort of thing. It's a really well-rounded film. So thank you for watching, guys, and I apologise again for the 2 month gap in between my last video and now. It's just having to get used to going back to sixth form again, so a lot of work has been piled on us in the last couple of months, so I've been trying to get through all that. So thank you once again, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.